Welcome to the latest episode of Drone News from Jeff Sibelius and LandandAirPhotos.com. Today I'll talk about the release of the new Pocket 2 handheld gimbal camera and the possibility of a Mavic Mini 2 drone. Let's start with the Pocket 2, which was released today. The Pocket 2 is the next generation of the Osmo Pocket, a gimbal and camera device that looks more like an electric toothbrush than a video camera. DJI has dropped the name Osmo and is just calling the new camera Pocket 2, and with this release they are addressing most of the criticisms people had of the original Pocket. Some of the improvements include a wider angle lens to make it a better vlogging camera. The original Pocket had a focal length somewhere around 26mm, which made it really tight for vlogging and selfie shots. The Pocket 2 has a focal length of 20mm, or a field of view of about 93 degrees. It also has an f1.8 aperture, an improvement from the Osmo Pocket's 2.0. The Pocket 2 also has four microphones built in to improve audio recording from all directions. It has a 1 over 1.7-inch quad Bayer sensor, that's larger than the sensor on the Mavic Air 2, incidentally, so it can produce stills up to 64 megapixels. It can shoot up to 8x slow motion at 1080p, and it has a built-in digital zoom of 4x for video at 1080p and 8x for stills. The Pocket 2 has a joystick built-in, and its adapter provides a 1/4-inch tripod mount to the bottom. With the Pocket, you had to buy wonky add-ons to get both of these features. The Pocket uses the Mimo app so you can see what you're doing on your phone. That's much better than the excruciatingly small screen on the back of the camera. The built-in battery lasts a little longer than the Pocket's, but it's still built-in, so you can't swap batteries when you need to. The Pocket 2 costs $349, and the Pocket 2 Creator Combo Pack costs $499. The Creator Combo Pack includes a do-it-all handle, wireless audio transmitter and microphone, tripod, and ultra-wide-angle adapter. For me, the Creator Combo Pack is worth the extra price if only for the wireless microphone, but it comes with several other features I'd like to use as well. If you're interested in getting the Pocket 2, I put a link in the description below. You can get it straight from DJI from that link. DJI didn't send me a demo Pocket 2 to try out. When you make DJI review videos that are called non-fanboy reviews, I guess I know why. Seriously, I'm giving this little camera a serious look, so my Osmo Pocket may be going the way of eBay very soon. So why am I talking about the Pocket 2? Look, we don't live by drone alone. We need to have a camera to shoot handheld shots as well. I like the Pocket. I used it for some B-roll in my videos, and it worked just fine. That built-in wireless mic really has me thinking about upgrading, though. It doesn't have a 1-inch sensor, so it won't compete with my Sony ZV-1 or other cameras, but for handheld mobile shooting, this looks really good. And the fact that it's made by DJI makes it a natural fit if you own DJI drones. I think you'll find footage from various DJI cameras play very well together, since they all have a fairly common color science, which will give you a more seamless look when you're mixing footage from handheld and drone cameras. If I just had DJI drones and I wanted a handheld camera, that reason alone would make the Pocket 2 a very strong contender in my book. The other reason why I'm talking about this camera is that we're hearing rumors of a new Mavic Mini 2 coming out as soon as November. So far, what we're hearing is that it's supposed to shoot 4K video. That was the real motivator for coming out with a new version so quickly. But the features of the Pocket 2 make me wonder about what the Mavic Mini 2 might include. Maybe it will have a quad Bayer sensor and shoot higher resolution stills. Will they improve the bitrate over the Mavic Mini? We're hearing that it will have bigger batteries. Will this thing still weigh less than 250 grams? And what about obstacle avoidance? I'm guessing we won't see that in the Mini 2. But no matter what features they build into this thing, will it be able to handle the wind better than the Mini? The Mini 2 is rumored to be more expensive than the Mini, but it can't be that much more expensive or it'll cost the same as the Mavic Air 2. And they can't put too much capability into this drone or it will compete with the Mavic Air 2. For me, the most important thing I want to know is, will the Mini 2 handle wind? If it doesn't, I don't really care what features they put into it. I see no reason to upgrade from the Mini if it can't fly in wind. For you guys thinking of buying a Mini, you may want to wait until we learn more about a Mini 2 before you pull the trigger. Or, maybe you want to get the Mini now, because it's going to be cheaper than what the Mini 2 will be. Or you could just grab the Mavic Air 2, which is a vastly superior drone. I put the links for the Mini and the Air 2 in the description below if you want to get one of those. DJI has really pulled out the stops on their handheld camera technology recently. They released the OM4, a gimbal for smartphones that works extremely well. My wife tried it out on our vacation in September, and she had a lot of fun with it. They've also released the DJI RS2, a powerful gimbal for larger cameras. Now they've released the Pocket 2. Will we see an Action 2 in the near future? And will we see the Mavic Mini 2 before Christmas? I don't know, but it's fun to speculate. And the Pocket 2 may be giving us a peek into what's in store for the Mini 2. Maybe. That's it for this episode of Drone News. Check out my playlist on screen for videos on the Mavic Mini, Mavic Air 2, and other drones. Hit the Cartoon Jeff icon to subscribe so you don't miss any future episodes. And your likes and comments are always appreciated. Thanks for watching.